Hi everyone. In this video, I'll be showing you how to create a table in MySQL by using Node.js. So let's get started. So for this, we need to install both MySQL and Express libraries. Only MySQL library will be used, but it's also good to install Express as well. So just go to your folder in Visual Studio Code and type npm I MySQL space Express. So once the libraries are installed, just go and create a file. Let me name it as main.js. All right, so at first, as usual, we will be importing the libraries. So it's const express equal to require express, and next one is going to be const mysql equal to require mysql. That's right. So once we are done with the import, we need to create our MySQL connection. So for that, const let it be the connection variable equal to MySQL, which is this variable that you have used. This should come here. Dot, it's going to be create connection and just open circular bracket and a curly bracket. So here we will be specifying our host, user, password and database. So host is going to be localhost over here, as I'm using my local MySQL DB. So it's localhost and just put a comma, and next one is going to be the user. So here I'm having just the default username as root. You need to specify like whatever you have. So this user root corresponds to the username that you are having for your connection. Okay, be careful over there. And the next one is going to be the password for your user. So that also same for the particular user, you will be having a specific password. So you need to like specify it correctly. So I will just enter the password that I have. All right. And next one is going to be the database. Okay. So you need to only specify the existing database. So for that, what I will do, I will just go to my MySQL workbench now. Yeah, I will just create a database for this. Create database. I will just do MySQL DB like that. And I will just now run it. Yeah, my database has been created. Let me just copy this new letters. So I'm just pasting it. Yeah, so now we are done with our MySQL connection. Just come to the next line. We need to use our connection variable, which is CON in my case, dot connect. This will take a callback function. So it's going to be function error. Basically, just catches the error, okay? Just open curly brackets. And if any error, let's just console that error. If error, let's just do console.log error. And in case if we aren't having any error, okay? So let's just have a else block over here, else. And here we'll be specifying the query for creating a table, okay? So it's going to be where SQL, you can just name it as anything. I'm just naming it as SQL equal to, and in this we have to specify our query. So the query is going to be same as we use in our MySQL. Okay, it's going to be like the same thing. So let me do that. So I will do in caps. So it's create table. Let me name it as my table. Open circular bracket. Let it have ID of type int. Put a comma and name of type varchar of size. Let me do 10. Yeah, I think I have done it perfectly. Yeah, that's fine. And just come to the next line. So you need to put con dot query. Okay, query. And within that, open circular bracket. So here we will be passing our variable. That is this query variable that we have assigned now. So it's going to be SQL, comma. So it takes a callback function basically. So it's going to be error, comma, result, or you can just put anything, because we are not going to get any result or data. We're just only going to create a table. So result won't be used. Only error will be used. So just put an arrow function over here. And same thing, if any error, that will be caught by this error variable over here. And let's just console.log error. And in case if we aren't having any error, the else block will be triggered, and in that we will have console.log I'll do table created. That's it. I guess now we are good to go, and we won't be using here the Express because we aren't doing anything with the server side code. I told you to install Express because after this we will be doing the CRUD operation. So for that Express will be needed. So it's always better to install Express as well. So now let me just go to my MySQL workbench and refresh this. So here you can see I'm having my MySQL DB, this one. So it has no tables currently. I can't even click it. So once we run this code, we will be having our table, my table over there. So let me just now run it. So for running it, it's going to be node, our .js file, which is main.js, and just hit enter. So here you can see I'm getting table created in the console, which means that we aren't having any errors over here. So now if I go to my MySQL workbench, and if I just now refresh it, so here you can see inside my MySQL DB, I am having tables. So this tables was empty before a moment. Now it has a table named my table. And if I just go to columns, here you can see it has ID and name of type varchar 10, ID is of type int. So that which means that our code has successfully worked without any errors. So but there is an issue with this code. Okay, so if I just now stop it and rerun it again, so again I am running it node main.js. So I will be getting an error over here. So it says that table my table already exists. So the reason we are getting this error is because it is again trying to run this particular command, and this table is already there. We have my table already created. So if we try to rerun it again, we'll be getting an error. Okay, we already exist error. So to solve this error, it's pretty much simple. Like here, you are just going to go to the query and you're going to add this particular phrase. So it's going to be create table if not exist. So it will only create table if that particular table does not, it is in present. So we can also change the console, okay, because we are having, the table has been already created. So we need to have like this, we'll just go with connected, okay. That makes sense, I guess. So now let's just save it. So while giving the query at first itself, you need to give this, okay. So I could have told this at first itself because I wanted you to show you the importance of this. Okay, why we need to use this and what error will it cause if it is induced. So that's the reason I didn't show it at first. So it's really good to have this as a statement in case if you're creating a table manually through code, or else you can just go here and create a table and basically just connect to that table. Okay, that's also like quite easy. So if you want through Node.js code, you basically like follow this. And now let me just stop it, Control C, and again run it. Yeah, so this time you can see I'm getting connected. Basically like it's really, really simple, and make sure you don't forget to use this particular step or line. So I hope you would have found this video useful. Mine is a programming channel. I've done many videos in C, C++, Java, Python, Blender, as well as Node.js, React.js, SQL queries. So do check out the videos of my channel. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.